Hello everyone, we are discussing about the components of LT switchgear. First of all, what do you mean by LT? LT means low tension or low voltage switchgear. So we will discuss about the components of LV switchgear. Already we discussed about switch fuse unit, miniature circuit breaker, molded case circuit breaker. Now we will discuss about ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker. Okay, ELCB, the full form of ELCB is earth leakage circuit breaker. Please underline this point, earth leakage. So the complete operation of ELCB is depending upon this word only, earth leakage. So you can understand by this word, earth leakage. So, and again, in this earth leakage circuit breaker, there are two types: voltage operated ELCB and second one is current operated ELCB. So this one will be discussed later. So now we will discuss about ELCB, voltage operated ELCB. So don't worry, I will clearly explain from this diagram. So please try to understand as possible, as easy. So first of all, what is ELCB? ELCB is basically an electrical wiring device. This is the electrical wiring device, complete set of these combination, these components is called ELCB. This is an electrical wiring device that disconnects the circuit, whenever the leakage current flows through the human body or the current is not balanced between the phase conductor. So this is actually the definition. So I will clearly explain you. So what are the components in this diagram? CB means circuit breaker. This is a switch fuse unit, RYB, three phases with neutral are connected to the load. Okay, so first of all we will discuss about these two components. So we will start the operation. Three-phase supply is connected to the load, if in case it is a three-phase induction motor. So then three-phase supply is connected to the three-phase induction motor, that is load, then it will operate smoothly. Okay, if under normal conditions, this is all are very happy because the currents IR, IY, IB are circulating in these three-phase with the help of neutral also. So the currents are circulating in three-phase manner. So if in case any short leakage occurs in the load, I mean in case any leakage current occurred in the load through the earth. So I will clearly explain you. So in case this is IR, so IR current, IY current, IB current, there are three phase currents with neutral current, IN current. So if it is a balanced condition, I mean if there is no leakage currents, the currents all are in balanced condition, I mean the incoming currents is equal to outgoing currents. So if in case any leakage current occurred, okay, if in case any earth leakage current occurred, then the incoming current is not equal to the outgoing current. It means imbalance. So not balanced the currents. So in case any, for example, it is incoming current is 10 amperes, then the leakage current is 1 amp, then the return current will be 9 amperes. So I will clearly explain you. If it is a 10 amperes, equal leakage 1 amperes, here 9 amperes. Then what happens here? Incoming current is not equal to the outgoing currents. Okay, well, very good, because of the leakage current. If in case any leakage current occurred, then the same leakage current will pass through the relay to the ground because of the parallel connection. So you think about, please think about this. If in case any leakage current occurred, then the same parallel connection occurred through the relay. So the leakage current is flows through the relay to the ground. Then there is a voltage difference. I mean, if in case any current flows through the device or wire, then there is a voltage. So because of the voltage across the relay is the voltage operated device which sends the signal to the circuit breaker. If in case any signals occurred in relay, then it will send to the circuit breaker. So it is a just a sensing device only. Relay is a sensing device. So when the current flows through the relay, then there is a voltage difference occurred in across the relay. Then that immediately relay sends the signal to the circuit breaker. Then the circuit breaker trips the main supply. So when the relay sends the signal to the circuit breaker, then circuit breaker will trips the, switch off the supply immediately. Okay, I think you can understand it easily. It is the safest device to detect and trip against the electrical leakage currents. Okay, please underline this point. This device is a safest device to detect and trip against the leakage currents. Thus, ensure protection against electric shock caused by the direct contacts. Okay, this is the complete operation of ELCB, but it is a voltage operated ELCB. Now we will discuss about current operated ELCB. It has another name, RCCB. RCCB means residual current circuit breaker. Here also, please underline this point, residual current. Residual means minimization of the current. So this circuit breaker will operate on the minimization of the current. It will indicate in the name. Okay, this is the diagram. Please don't confuse from this diagram. I will explain each and every part. L means line, N means neutral. So this is completely supply. So this supply is connected to the magnetic coil. Magnetic means it is the electromagnetic coil. So this is a circular iron bar. This circular iron bar has winding. So the line wire is connected to the iron core in the clockwise direction and to the load, and return wire is also has a winding to the iron core and it will connect it to the neutral. So this is the, if under normal condition the line supply is going, so we will switch on it. When the switch is on position, the current, line current, will passes through this line to the iron bar. Then here some electromagnetic field will be produced and this current will passes through the load and load to the return coil. Return coil is called secondary coil, entering coil is called primary coil. So this coil has also induced an electromagnetic field, then this current will passes through the neutral. Okay, this is the current path. So okay, coming to the coil. So when the current passing, so entering current is 10 amperes, leaving current is also 10 amperes because of there is no leakage currents. Okay, so entering current and leaving currents are same. So the electromagnetic field is same. Here also electromagnetic field is same because of the number of turns are equal. So this is N1. Okay, primary number of turns is N1. Secondary number of turns is N2. Then primary current is I1. Then secondary current is I2. It means both are equal. If number of turns is equal, if current is passing same, then the magnetic field also equal. I am saying about the magnetic field. Okay, so please, this is MMF, magnetomotive force. So please observe here, the direction of the winding is clockwise. So this is anti-clockwise. Okay, both are in opposite position. The magnetic field produced here is clockwise, here anti-clockwise. So the differential fluxes will become zero because of the both are in opposite position. So clearly I write here, the polarity of the phase winding and neutral winding on the core is so chosen that in normal condition MMF of one winding opposes that of other. It means normal condition same current will flowing, so then the same with the help of same number of turns, the magnetomotive force is also same, but both are in opposite direction, so there is no difference in the magnetic field. Okay, in case there is a leakage current, earth leakage, so there is a earth leakage currents, then what happens? The return current will becomes reduced. Reduced means this is a residual current. So when the leakage current occurred, then the return current is becomes 9 amperes. So number of turns are equal, but the current is different. Then the magnetomotive force MMF is also a, there is a difference. So in case here the value is, magnetomotive force value is 10, then here is 9, then the difference is 1. That one, that the value of one magnetomotive force will connected to the another extra coil, sensing coil. That the difference, because of it is clockwise, it is anti-clockwise. So the difference flux, I mean difference magnetomotive force will be connected to the sensing coil. Then immediately this coil has a induced voltage. This induced voltage will be connected to the relay. Because of the supply voltage to the relay will operate, because of relay is a voltage operated device. Then immediately be sends to the signal, sorry, it sends signal to the circuit breaker, then circuit breaker will opens the switch or trips the main switch. Okay, this is all about complete operation. So now we will come to the another point. Under fault condition, there is a difference in MMF, I told you. So when the fault current occurred, then the difference in MMF. So a result flux exists and trips coil is energized. The resultant flux is connected to the sensing coil. Okay, this will be energized. Then immediately induced voltage will occur. That because of that voltage, the relay will be operated. So trip coil further isolated the supply to the load. Okay, this is working principle of residual current circuit breaker. Okay, these two are very very important and easy. Okay, thank you very much. If you have any doubts, please comment in the comment box.